Hey there designers, it's Contrast here, and in this video, I'm going to teach you a secret technique that you can use to create realistic shadings in just minutes without using the brush tool. Now this technique requires zero prior experience, so if you're a beginner, don't feel too overwhelmed. We're not going to be painting and you most likely won't need a drawing tablet. Now for our software, we're going to be using a free browser version of Photoshop called Photopea. The link is in the description if you want to follow along. And by the end of this video, I'm going to show you an exclusive sneak peek of our upcoming product, the Clothing Asset Pack Volume 2. So for this video, I'm going to shade the suit I made previously, not that long ago. You can watch how I made it by clicking on the video in the top right corner of your screen, or you can download the project file on Patreon. The link is in the description. Now let's get started by looking up images of wrinkled silk online. You can go through different sites like Adobe Stock, Shutterstock to get high quality images. Make sure to get images that have a white background. This will make more sense later. We can also use some of these shading presets on our new clothing asset pack, but more on that later. Now once you've chosen an image, the next step is to set the blending mode to multiply. That removes all the white pixels and leaves the black pixels. You can also play around with the other blending modes and see what works well with the image. Make sure to save a duplicate of this layer. This will make more sense later. Now I'm guessing by now you already know where I'm going with this. The next step is to scale the shading to the appropriate size. Having a reference would really help in this part of the process. We can use this to help us better understand how shading works in the real world. Let's try our best to replicate this with our shading. Now I'm not super satisfied with where the seams are placed, but we can fix that by warping the image. To do that, press Ctrl or Command T to open up the transform controls. Then right click on the image and select warp. You can adjust this however you want. Let's decrease the opacity to make it more subtle. I'm going to decrease it to about 80%, but you can change the opacity however you like. The next step is to remove the unwanted parts. We can do that by using a layer mask. Now if you don't know how layer mask works, here's a quick rundown. You can add the layer mask by pressing the small icon under the layers panel. To remove certain parts, select the layer mask thumbnail and grab the brush tool. Make sure to set it to soft round, then set the foreground color to black. If you want to remove certain parts, set the foreground color to black. If you want to bring back certain parts of the image, set the foreground color to white. Press X to toggle between the foreground color and the background color. We can go one step further by adding some highlights. To do that, let's make sure to grab the soft round brush. Make sure the foreground color is set to white. Then simply paint the highlights on the appropriate areas. We can use the eraser to make the highlights more subtle. Make sure to set the blending mode to overlay. We can make the highlights look better by adding a Gaussian blur filter. Just set the radius however you like. Now just repeat this process throughout the whole template. We can reuse the shading image that we duplicated earlier. You can use warp to add some variations to the shading. Now here's the final result. Shading the rest of the suit took me around 10 minutes off screen. Now you will probably get a totally different result. If you want to download the project file, make sure to check the link in the description. So in this video, we learned that we can use different silk images as our shading. We also learned that we can use different blending modes to make the image transparent. We also learned how to use layer mask and how you can use the brush tool to add highlights. And lastly, we also learned that we can use warp to add some variations to the shading itself. Now in some cases, you might encounter issues with these shading images, but don't worry, we've created a solution for this. We've created custom shading images designed specifically to help you make better shading. Now if you want to get this for yourself, make sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon to get notified when we finally release the Clothing Asset Pack Volume 2. If you enjoyed this video and you feel like you learned something valuable, please consider subscribing. If you want to see our previous video, click the video on the left. And a huge thank you to everyone who supports this channel on Patreon. This video wouldn't be possible without you guys, so thank you. And if you want to be part of this exclusive community and get early access to videos and even 10 bonus clothing assets each and every month, the link is in the description.